Hi, I'm Amy Baez, pediatric occupational therapist and founder of Play It Be, if you don't already know me. I'm here to provide you with some playful solutions and powerful results. Today, I'm doing an interview with Reverend Juan Del Hierro. He is the associate minister at Union de Bay in Miami, Florida, and he is also on the board of directors at Unity World Headquarters. Plus, he is a very involved and proud father. So today we're going to be talking a little bit about spirituality and parenting and how they're intertwined. Hi, Juan. How are you?
Hey. Hi, Amy. I'm great. Excited to be with you today.
Well, thank you for meeting with me this week. I know you've been kind of busy. Can I call you a grandpa? Is that the right word?
A grandpa that is multiplying grandkids as we speak.
We should clarify a little bit for people who don't know. Your goat had a goat, right?
My goat had a goat. And 2 days earlier, my outdoor kitten had kittens. So, and they just came into the house.
Oh my goodness.
We have four kittens and a baby goat that were just born in the last week or so.
Oh my goodness. Wow. Well, I think we should get into a topic about pets a little bit later.
And the ability to say no.
Maybe that should be part of the discussion. So, but first I want to talk to you a little bit about what we are here for. So I wanted to talk a little bit about spirituality and parenting and how they can be intertwined. And I thought since Father's Day is approaching, I really wanted to speak to a father in particular. So who better to have talk to than you? So thank you again for joining us. So that the audience is a little bit understanding of like where we're coming from, I want you to first just provide like a definition of what spirituality is and a little bit about how you got into it.
Great. Well, you know, first of all, I think spirituality will mean different things to different people. The way that I see it is that spirituality is just an awareness and a continued journey into the relationship between myself and the God of my being. And so spirituality for me is really just about uncovering the connection that I have with the divine and the ways in which I can sort of live from that awareness.
Beautiful. And how did you become a minister? In short story, I know you can tell a long story.
Especially because that's part of the ministerial training, how to make longer a story, like I'm doing just now. Yeah. I actually just happened to be invited to the community that I currently serve at, Unity on the Bay, over 17 years ago. And something in that community just sort of opened up possibilities for me in my personal life, in my work life, and the ways in which I sort of shared my talents and actually even became more aware of some of those skills, some of those passions. And so Unity on the Bay, the community, has really been a huge part of just saying, you know, this is possible for you. Not only is this possible, but this is your calling. And here we are to support you in this journey. So I've been a minister in this community now for a couple of years. I sort of grew up in the church and became now its associate minister.
Wonderful. Yes, I've had the pleasure of seeing that transformation. I also saw you become a parent as well. So I'm wondering if you could talk a little bit about how your spirituality impacts your parenting.
First of all, you know, I was raised in a particular faith tradition, and I was raised in a somewhat religious family. And so I saw the benefit of community, of a religious or spiritual community. And it was always something that I wanted to share with my son, Lucas. For me, spirituality is really giving me the tools and the practices to be a better father and to allow myself sort of the space for me to just feel into what it's like to really allow my son to know his self-worth, know his connection with the divine, know just how sacred he is. And so although I try to be as conscious of that as possible in every moment, you know, it really is something that I lean on. You know, how is this going to support him in recognizing that he's whole, recognizing that he is part of a network of loving, wonderful energy? How is he going to be able to contribute that? And through that, really recognize just how amazing of an expression of the divine he is. And so I think it's just something that I can lean on. And you know, the same kind of mindfulness and the same kind of spiritual practices that I've learned and that have brought me a greater sense of peace and understanding are some of the same that I try to use with him and support him in his journey.
Yeah, I think that's a great way to start. Can you explain a little bit about like what that looks like exactly? And also at what age do you feel like you really started to address that kind of directly?
Well, I can remember when he came home with us, just laying in bed and listening to a bunch of Karen Drucker music, who's this New Thought singer who really just speaks about that, like our wholeness and the way in which we're here to be expressions of love and our connection with the divine. So although it wasn't sort of an implicit conversation that I was having with Lucas at a week old, I really felt like he was sort of being instilled in that energy. So from a very early age, I just had that around in conversations with my spouse, you know, like, and Lucas was around, he could hear some of the ways in which we understood our own spirituality and understood how that played a role in our relationships. But I do remember probably about 3 or 4 years old when we really started reading to him, you know, incorporating specific books that reminded him of his truth, specific books that invited him to be okay with different challenges or situations that life may bring and be able to recognize that you could still be centered in that, you know? And so I was lucky enough to work at a Unity church. And so I would grab books from the bookstore and just bring them home and read it to him. And then as he got older, we started looking at implementing some of those practices, you know, that I mentioned, like just practices in breathing, right? So he'd have some tantrum or he'd be upset. And after I got over my upsetness and my, you know, the things that I had to work through, it was like, all right, can we breathe in this moment, you know? And a lot of resources from the website ConsciousDiscipline.com on how to become more mindful in those moments at an early age. And then little by little, just continue to add more, like a gratitude moment at dinner time, or even just a moment of mindfulness where, you know, around the dinner table, you know, we would just sort of stop and ask ourselves, all right, what's going on in this moment, right? Like, what are we thinking about? What's going on in our minds? How does our body feel? And so just kind of like trying to bring some playfulness in the mindfulness that we were together with.
Yeah, that's great. I think it's really important to address those types of things. I know I work a lot with breathing with kids and like body scanning, like really understanding their awareness of their body. And we often as therapists use what we call social stories. So it's kind of like you were saying with the books, it's like explaining like different scenarios, like how do you handle these things? And so those are really great ways to incorporate those kinds of practices with kids. And they don't really even know it, you know, it's like they don't really notice that you're addressing that. So that's great. I know you mentioned the resource, the Conscious Parenting. Is it a Conscious Parenting website?
ConsciousDiscipline.com.
Conscious Discipline. Sorry. Yeah. I'm sure there's a Conscious Parenting out there too.
I'm sure. And if not, we should actually buy that website right now.
Right now. But you talked about behavior. So I was wondering, I know that when I interview parents and talk to parents about just doing my own market research and such, parents who have kids in therapy or don't, they all stress that behavior is a big part of their daily like pain points or struggles. And so I know that mindfulness practices can help with that. So, and I feel like spirituality can too as well. I know you touched on it a little bit already. Do you have any other thoughts about how behavior and spirituality, like how you've addressed that? Because I feel like parents really struggle with this in particular, especially the way they were disciplined may not necessarily reflect how they want to discipline their children.
Right. Well, you know, and I think you've probably heard me say this before, but for me, like I jokingly say, like spirituality is not for the faint of heart, you know, because it's a practice and it's work and it can feel like a struggle sometimes to be present to things that were happening, you know, in the behavior of Lucas. And, you know, I've had some really great support systems to deal with that through therapy and through the school that Lucas is in. But really, for me, and I'll just speak for me as a father, my own spiritual practices have really supported me in becoming a little bit more aware of some of those triggers, right? Because I think one of the things that I've learned is, you know, when your child is triggered, try to be as mindful as possible that you're not being triggered. And then there's just these two energies sort of bumping up against each other. And so my daily meditation practice has really supported me in becoming a little bit more calm about certain situations. I also, you know, I get really wonderful reminders through my spiritual learning. So for example, there is a quote by Ram Dass, and or more like a frame of mind that he invites us into, which is just says, love, serve, remember. And I printed it out and put it right on my kitchen wall because I was finding that I was having a really hard time in the mornings. You know, I was making breakfast and getting Lucas ready and, you know, going from one activity to the other, you know, which can be difficult for children. Yeah. I was kind of losing it sometimes. And so I had that reminder, you know, like I'm here to love him. I'm here to serve him. I'm here to remember his truth and support him in remembering his. And so those are some of the things that like how I felt like I became a more mindful father or tried to, right? Like it's a work in progress. But with Lucas's behavior, it was also as much as possible. And sometimes we did it better than other times, or we do it better than other times, but just inviting him to actually love, serve, remember in his own language, right? And so I think he saw some of what I modeled, you know, like Lucas, for example, loved this little yoga book that we had. And so at nighttime, he would ask us to do yoga with him before bedtime, and it really helped relax him. And it made the behavior around going to sleep easier, you know, and different things. And then, you know, he would see me meditate, and sometimes he's just like sitting next to me, you know, and it helps him calm down. So there's different ways in which we've been able to sort of incorporate that and support his behavior with some of these practices.
Yeah, I think it's really important. You touched on some important words, like modeling is a really big thing, like the matching of energies. I'm often trying to remind parents that if, you know, your child's really upset and you're raising your voice too, like it's just, you're just like in competition with each other. And like, you really have to kind of like bring it down in order to get them to come back to where you want them to be. And modeling is a huge thing. I think it's really great, in particular, just the idea that you're so involved as a parent. I know that I've seen a lot more fathers becoming more and more involved. I compared to like when I first started as a therapist, I would rarely ever see a dad. And then now I have quite a few right now who are like the primary person that I'm working with their child. So that's why I really wanted to have a father to speak with and to kind of share that perspective. You've been pretty open about the fact that Lucas has been in therapy before. You already talked about a little bit how that's impacted you as a parent. Has any of that helped you back to like your job as a minister?
Well, here's the thing about spirituality. For me, spirituality says that everything is interconnected, you know? And so the practices I learn at work can really support me at home. The practices that I learn at home really support me at work if I'm open to seeing it. You know, one of the things that I really appreciated, all right, am I allowed to say you were Lucas' therapist?
Go ahead.
Okay, good. So, you know, Amy, in the ways that you nurtured Lucas, right? Like, first of all, speaking of modeling, you know, you were a model for me on how to nurture him and support him in the different things that he needed to accomplish. But one of the other things that really struck me, you know, is the ability of you as a therapist and another therapist to, you know, be able to highlight the things that he's doing really well, and then just look at the things that he has difficulty with as something that just needs to be sort of learned really supported. And so, I mean, I remember, you know, you being on the floor in my house with Lucas trying to get certain muscles, you know, stronger. Mm-hmm. To me, I mean, that is spirituality, like acknowledging that we're whole, acknowledging that we are, you know, expressions of good. And there's some muscles that, you know, are a little stronger than others. And the work of spirituality is to be able to practice enough so that all of us are really, like, all of our faith muscles, all of our spiritual muscles at a point where they really supported me in life. And so that's the way that I see it's sort of what's happened at home with Lucas' behavior has supported me personally. And of course, then that gets shared through the ways that I serve our community.
Yeah, I get to hear your storytelling, even though I'm no longer a therapist. I haven't been, but I still get to see his journey and your journey in parenting too. So it's really nice to see. So now that you have quite a few pets in your home, I've lost count, but I feel like pets can often be a source of mindfulness practice for children and really getting in touch with their spirituality. Can you share a little bit about your experience with that?
Oh, I love that way of seeing it in that question. And as I just sit here, I mean, we really did want to have animals. I don't know if we wanted to have as many animals, 2 dogs, 2 cats, 4 kittens, a goat, a baby goat, and a bearded dragon. we were really aware that we wanted to have something that Lucas could be responsible for, right? Mm-hmm. And I think especially with our cat Tiger Lily, like Lucas really takes responsibility for how Tiger Lily is being loved on. And so he's much more conscious about the way in which he speaks to Tiger Lily, the way in which he plays with Tiger Lily has sort of evolved, right? Like he was a little bit more rough with her at the very beginning. And he became more aware that that's just not the way Tiger Lily wants to be played with. And actually that may not be healthy. And so he becomes more aware about himself, you know, in relationship with his pets. And I also believe that, you know, with the ability of us having as many animals, and I mean, he videotaped the birth of our baby goat last week. No. You know, that he is able to really sort of acknowledge sort of like the interconnectedness of things. And also, you know, recognize that there's this sort of like natural flow of life taking place, you know, which is, I think, also a spiritual practice to know that, you know, nature takes its course and we can ride it and we can't, or we can fight it, you know, and being able to ride it feels a lot much more harmonious.
Wonderful. So I wanted to ask you some fun questions as well. So first, I just want to know, what is your favorite thing to play with Lucas, aside from playing with the animals?
Oh my gosh. So I really love being outdoors with Lucas. So we built him a whole little set outside
a
with
a fort. It's kind of like a fort, right?
Well, the fort now belongs to the goat.
Oh, of course it does.
The fort became our barn. but he has quite a few things in our trees. And so we love to play out there. I love to swing with him, you know, like, because in those moments, I'm just like really present with him. And we just, I swing him, you know, and I push him. And he feels very free. And sometimes he feels a little scared, and we talk a little bit about why he was scared, and we just have some really wonderful conversations there. I'm also somebody that likes to do things with my hands. And so I love right now that for Lucas, it is playtime to be building things in our backyard. Actually, like, he'll tell me he has to go to Home Depot and give me a list of all the things that we need to get so that he can build something. And so I really love that kind of play with him.
Right. Awesome. Okay. So I have a quick quick round of questions.
Okay, quick.
Okay. So what is a guilty pleasure?
Bad TV, but don't tell Lucas.
Okay. Your dream vacation.
My dream vacation. I'm going to Hawaii in July. So it's a dream come true.
I'm a little jealous. I've never been to Hawaii. Hidden talents.
Oh my gosh. Hidden talents. Well, I can build. I can build a lot of stuff.
Yes. I thought you might have said telling bad jokes, but.
That's not a hidden talent. Everybody knows how talented I am at that.
Yes. What was your favorite childhood game or toy?
Oh my gosh. I have no idea why it just popped into my head, but the game Sorry. That's just what popped into my head.
I love Sorry. I played it on our vacation over the summer, and it was like this 1972 version of it. And I was like, this thing was created before I was born. So yeah, so I love Sorry. So I understand. All right, last one. If you could have a superpower, what would it be?
I'd love to sing. And if you've heard me sing, you know why I believe that's a superpower.
Very funny. I love it. All right. So where can my audience learn more about you and follow your journey?
Oh, wonderful. Well, you know, I'm a product of the spiritual community that I'm a part of. So everyone can go to unityonthebay.org and just see the many ways in which I get to sort of practice my spirituality and invite others to practice theirs. I do have a personal website, which is Juan del Hierro, J-U-A, well,
I'll put
yeah,
it
I'm sure you'll put it. Yeah. So my personal website is juandelhierro.com. You can just find me on Instagram, on Facebook, but I'd love to connect with as many people as possible. It's a wonderful thing to be able to create community and connection, especially when it comes to how we raise our kids.
Yeah. And you also do a lot of writing for publications often. So there's some of those as well. Is it particular magazines that you often contribute to, or would you like to just, I can also just share some links if they're digital. I'm not sure if they're digital as well.
There's some digital links that you can use. So I have been invited to write for different magazines, like Parenting Magazine, GLAAD, and then publications within Unity. So I've been really blessed with those opportunities.
Awesome. So yeah, so we'll try to share those links as well.
Yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to share?
So one of the things that I just really would love to share with everybody is that there are so many resources, right? And so, Amy, I'm going to give you a shout out because you have been a great resource for our family. There's people like Amy, therapists like Amy, websites like consciousdiscipline.com. Researching is actually quite important, I think, as parents, to be on the lookout for different practices, tools that we can use. So even yesterday, I was playing around looking at a company's website that does some things with children. And there's a website called thewisemindproject.com, which is all about mindfulness that I found. It's just in Fort Lauderdale. So I'm going to get to know them a little bit more in the coming weeks.
I should too. Interesting.
Yeah. Cool. Do you remember Laura Duksa? She wrote that book, I Love You More, I believe. She used to go to Unity.
I remember the cover very well.
Yeah. And so she had moved up to Fort Lauderdale, and I was just looking up a website. It's actually, I don't know why I call it a company. It's CSL, Center for Spiritual Living's website. And they use some of their video clips as part of their Sunday lesson for kids. And so that led me down the rabbit hole. And I was able to find the Wise Mind Project. And I already sent them an email, because they provide not only videos, but training and other resources for parents, for schools, and for churches.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that resource.
Yeah.
You're making me look even better.
That's the point.
All right. Well, thank you so much for talking with me today. I know you have to go about and go pick up Lucas from school. I appreciate you volunteering your time to talk to me and sharing all your wonderful knowledge with everybody. So thank you, and happy early Father's Day to you and to Tom.
Well, thank you, Amy. And I just want to say thank you for the invitation, and you know, thank you for the ways in which you played a really beautiful role in the life of Lucas. And now through this, in the life of so many other kids.
Thank you so much. Bye. Did you enjoy that interview with Juan? I know I did. I could talk to him for hours. Actually, I have in the past. So I want to let you know that we have some information that he shared, some links that are going to be posted in the video description down below, so you could check out those resources. I know there's some that I am not even familiar with that I'm going to check out as well. And thanks to Juan for giving me a shout out for my therapy services. I really had no intention of mentioning that in the interview, but as you can see, it's kind of hard to not share when you've worked so intimately with someone. So thank you. Be sure to check out playap.com if you want additional resources, some of which are free, and some games that are for sale on the PlayApp website. Until the next video, I hope you have a playful day.